How do I transfer my system to a replacement drive? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. My hard drive states that failure is imminent and I should replace it immediately. My questions are as follows. When I replace my hard drive, will I need to install a new operating system? Is there a way to clone my current hard drive completely, including my operating system? If I'm able to clone my entire hard drive, will I need hardware or some device between the old hard drive and the new while I do the transfer? What's the best way to save my existing files if I can't salvage my entire hard drive? Are there software programs that can help me do this? Indeed, there is software to help. They're called backup programs, and there's something I talk about a lot. While there are many, many different ways to accomplish kind of what you've described here. What you've described is really, really common, by the way, to deal with a failing hard drive that then needs to be replaced. I want to go over what I consider to be the single best way to accomplish exactly what you're doing, mostly because it's exactly what I do. So the very, very first step, back up your existing hard drive. By that, I mean create an image backup of the existing hard drive, of everything on it, all the partitions, all the data, everything, to an external drive. If you don't have an external drive, get one. This is the way to make this happen. By backing up your existing system, you now have something that you'll have available when it comes time to put things back on a replacement drive. Now, if you've been paying attention to Ask Leo for any length of time, you'll know that this is something that you should already have. This is exactly the scenario that backing up is so critical for. My recommendation in general is that you take a periodic full system image backup once a month, and then daily do incremental backups. So you've never lost anything more than a portion of a day. By doing that, you already have the exact image backup you're going to need for a replacement hard drive. Now, you specifically are very, very, very fortunate in that you're getting warnings that your hard drive is about to die. Most of the time, a hard drive will die suddenly and without any warning. That means you won't have an opportunity to pay attention to a warning and make an image backup right now. You'll be relying on whatever your backup strategy was up until that point. Make sure your backup strategy is in place and that you are taking those image backups regularly. Now, if your hard drive ends up dying to the point where you can't boot your system, you can't reliably make an image backup of it, you can't run the backup software because things are that broken, there's one other straw to grasp at. With the backup program of choice, I tend to recommend either Macrium, Reflect, or ESUS to do, but there are others out there that will do this as well. What you'll do in order to eventually restore your backup is create what's called an emergency disk or a rescue disk. This is either a CD or a DVD or a bootable USB stick onto which the backup software writes a copy of itself that you can then boot into. So you would take your machine. If you weren't able to make a backup image and you can't install the backup software on it, you would instead boot your machine from this rescue disk. The thing most people don't realize about rescue disks is that while they are optimized and perhaps even default to getting ready to restore a backup image, they can also create one. So by using this rescue disk, booting from this rescue disk, you can then at least have a try at making an image backup of the machine without necessarily having to be able to boot into it. Again, make that image backup to an external hard drive because you'll use it in a step coming up. Next up, install the replacement drive. Just swap it out. That'll depend on exactly what kind of a machine you've got, what the form factor is, what kind of a replacement drive you end up getting. All depends on the specifics of your situation. I can't speak to that, but your computer's manufacturer can. Very often, it's simply a matter of making sure you've got the right size, both physically and that the replacement drive is at least as big, if not bigger, in terms of capacity than the one you are currently using. Most of the time, the physical size is an easy one to just sort of check off. It'll be difficult depending on how long you've had your machine, it'll be difficult to find a hard drive that isn't bigger than what you already have, which is kind of a nice side effect of replacing the hard drive anyway. You end up with more space when we're all done. Next up, well, remember that rescue disk? This is the time where you boot from that rescue disk and then run the restore. The backup software on the rescue disk will allow you to take the backup image that you saved on the external drive and copy it onto the replacement drive. That's the point of an image backup. Once it's done copying, all of your partitions are there, all of your data is there, your installed operating system, there's almost nothing else you need to do. Once that restore is finished and you reboot your machine from the replacement hard drive, it's almost as if nothing happened at all. Everything should be there and be working. Now, there is one final, I'll just call it a tweak, and that's, remember, I said that your replacement hard drive is likely to be larger than the one you had, which is great, gives you more space. What it does mean, though, is that depending on the backup software you're running and the specifics of your situation, you may need to tweak the partitions on that replacement hard drive. Depending on the backup software, it may simply restore exactly what you had before, and any extra space on the hard drive will be unused. Or in some cases, I think backup software is smart enough to actually extend the partition to use up all the space, but not all of them are, and it's not always possible to do that simply. If you're lucky, you'll be able to do that with the built-in Windows Disk Manager. If it gets a little bit more complicated because of some of the other partitions on your hard drive, you may need to use a dedicated tool to rearrange partitions, but there's an article on askleo to do that. But the bottom line is that even if you do nothing else, after the restore, you're back in business. Then it becomes a tweak, an optimization to make use of the additional space that you may have got because your replacement hard drive is bigger than the original. But that's the bottom line. That's the scenario. Basically, take a backup or have a backup, replace the hard drive, and restore the backup image to the replacement hard drive, and you're pretty much done. It really can be that simple. I've done it multiple times, and it's actually very, very cool to have that replacement hard drive in there, reboot the machine, and have everything just sort of magically come back as if nothing had ever happened. For updates, for comments, for related links, and more, visit askleo.com/4261. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.